Good morning. It's Sunday morning in Amsterdam. I'm speaking very quietly because it feels like the whole city is asleep. It's so quiet. Really nice. Anyway, so we're just gonna go take a walk to Action. Action is, how do you describe it? It's sort of like a discount homeware store. So you probably wouldn't go there to get something super great quality, but if you need something that will do for now, that's sort of the place to go. It's a bit like Kmart in Australia. So we're going to go there to get some Christmas decorations, if we can find any, for our tree, because we finally bought a tree from Blocker. That's another homeware store. But yeah, that's it. Like, I think after that we might go grab some coffees, maybe hit up the bakery, go to the park. Let's see how the day goes and how much we buy from Action as well. Just went to the coffee shop. Something really cool about Amsterdam, which we totally didn't expect, is when we moved into our place, we obviously had to register with the municipality, and then suddenly we got this mystery box, and I thought, oh, maybe it's something we ordered or it's like an advertisement. But actually inside it had all these little cards, and you can like take it to coffee shops or like the local Blocker, which is a homeware store, and get a discount or free things. So we just went to a coffee shop called White Label Coffee. Basically it was like a voucher for either two free cups of coffee or one bag of ground coffee. So yeah, that's pretty cool. So we got a free bag of the ground coffee, and we also just bought a takeaway large coffee to support the coffee shop too. Their sizes are so different. Like, I asked for a large one and it's really like an Australian small, I would say, or medium at best. That's why everyone here is like so fit and trim. So this is the coffee we got. I'm gonna try it now. I got a flat white with oat milk. I don't know if the owners are maybe Australian or something, because I feel like a flat white is an Australian thing. A lot of coffee shops don't understand if you say I want a flat white. It's actually quite good. I would say it's worth the money, but it's a bit of a luxury. Like, for a large coffee, it was, what, 470 euros?
4 euros.
4 euros. That's a lot. But then again, coffee in Australia is really expensive too. Anyway, now we're gonna walk to the park, and it's still really quiet here, so I expect the park will be pretty much the same. It'll be all to ourselves. package. Yesterday I ordered a winter coat off Bever, B-E-V-E-R. It's already getting quite cold in the Netherlands and the coats that I have just aren't really gonna cut it. And there was a really great deal on Bever. This jacket was 40% off. Pretty good deal, but let's see if it fits. I'm gonna open now and let's try it on together and see. How does it look so far? Looks good. It's not the roomiest jacket. This is an extra small, which is why it was on sale. Obviously, Dutch people are very well known for being a lot taller, so probably this wouldn't fit a lot of Dutch people, but I'm 158 centimeters, so it's working out well for me so far. Let me just have a look at the mirror. Okay, so far so good. I'm not very good at this. This is clearly not a fashion vlog. I've taken a better look at the jacket now and I feel like I should just very briefly touch on what kind of things came with this jacket, the specs of the jacket. So I've just laid it down on our living room rug. This is how it looks. It's actually called a 3-in-1 jacket, which means the outer layer is rainproof and windproof. And then inside, you've got a down jacket, which you can actually remove using the zipper. So when it's not so cold and you want something that's just rainproof, you can actually just unzip it. But for now, I'm probably just gonna keep it because it is getting quite cold. It is down, and according to the website, it was sustainably sourced down. The brand is Shakucha. Comes with pockets, always handy. And it also has inside pockets too, which is really useful if you want to keep something important or you need to keep something warm. That's always a nice feature to have. And there's also like these drawstrings here too. So that means you can tighten it up around the waist to just further windproof your jacket and also provide it a bit more shape. Essentially, so far, I'm really happy with the jacket. It fits me well. That was an extra small. And I would say I'm usually a size small. So this one actually runs a little bit larger than what your usual size is. And most importantly, it's a 3-in-1 jacket. So it's windproof, rainproof, and it's gonna keep me warm. I ordered the jacket last night at, I think, 8 p.m. and I received it today at 3 p.m. So it was next day delivery. And the best thing about Bever as well was that it's free delivery and also you can return the product for free within 365 days, which is insane. It's unheard of. Usually, you know, a normal store would give you a 30-day return window. This jacket, it retails for, let me see, €219.95, so €220, and I managed to get it for €130. So yeah, just thought I'd share that little tidbit. And if you are on the search for a winter jacket in the Netherlands, highly recommend Bever. Check it out. Hey everyone, we decided to hit up some museums in the local area. So today we're going to the Dutch Resistance Museum, which should be really good. I am really tired today though. Didn't really sleep very well last night. Luckily, got the face mask, so not only does it protect you from the coronavirus, it also hides half your face when you're not feeling so amazing.
Opeens is Nederland bezet. Er lopen allemaal vreemde soldaten door de straat, door jouw straat. Wat doe je op zo'n moment? Wat kan je doen? Negeer je het en ga je gewoon door met je normale leven? Kies je de kant van de nieuwe machthebbers? Of probeer je tegen de bezetters te verzetten? Daarover gaat deze film en de tentoonstelling die je zo gaat bekijken.
So we just finished up at the Dutch Resistance Museum. It was really good. Obviously, you know, everyone says that they would resist, they would, you know, save people, all of that kind of stuff in hindsight. But when you're actually faced with a life or death situation yourself, a lot of people probably wouldn't have the guts to resist. So essentially the museum was just all about that and paying homage to people who actually stood up and said no to occupation and even tried to save other people who they didn't know themselves. So obviously they were very, very brave.